Hi friends, welcome. In this video, we are going to plot and calculate the catchment area on SI sheet using AutoCAD software. Actually, we have the regular procedure in which we will be taking the print of SI sheet to the scale and we will be transferring it to the graph sheet using a tracing paper and we will calculate the area. But in this video, we are not going to discuss about that. And indeed, we are going to discuss about the procedure in which we can calculate using AutoCAD software. Now, let us see how to plot it. Before going into the topic, I would like to tell you about some information regarding the SI sheet. This is the topo sheet or SI sheet with the sheet number on the top right corner. The sheet number is 65n/3. The topo sheets are available in the website of Survey of India up to the scale of 1:50,000 free of cost and the remaining are to be bought. In this sheet, we can observe that there are a lot of lines and different colors. All the green color which we can see is the dense forest area or jungle, and the yellow color is the cultivable area and the white one is the uncultivable area. And if we take a look closer, we can see that there are some black lines and some brown lines. In the brown lines, we can see that there are some lines which are denoted by numbers and they are thick. And now you can see the image in which you can see the contour lines. As we have seen in the SI sheet, these brown color lines are called the contour lines. A contour line is the line joining the points of equal elevations. And the dark color lines which there is a number denoted is called the index contour. And the difference between the two successive contour lines is called the contour interval. This is another topo sheet with sheet number 65n/10. In this we can clearly see the contour intervals and contour lines. The distance between the two contour lines is 20 meters, that is the contour interval is 20 meters. Now we shall add 20 meters from 200 and see whether it is correct or not. Here it is 200, next 220, 240, 260, 280, and here it is 300, and here it is 300, 320, 340, 360, 380, it is 400, and so on. If we zoom out, we can see there are also some concentric circles which are formed by the contour lines. These concentric circles are called hills. In this picture, you can get the clear idea how the contour lines look like at the hill portions. Here, if you observe, near the hill portion, some lines are very nearby and some lines are distant. In this also, some lines are nearby in this portion and in this portion, they are distant. The closer contour lines indicate that the slope is steep and the distant contour lines indicate that the slope is gentle. We can see here two concentric circles which denotes that they are two hills side by side. Now, if you look at a stream close by, you can observe that whenever the contour lines intercept the stream, they are bending and forming a V shape. See, here this is a stream, and whenever the contours are intercepting, we can see that they formed a V shape like this. The stream started from here and it joined the larger one over here. Now in this, the tip of the V shape, here you can see the tip of the V shape, it is the source of water. That means the water is going in this direction.
You should remember it as a hint that the water flows into the tip of the V and water flows in the direction.
We shall see another area. Here we see this small stream is forming a V shape in this direction. That means this is the tip of the V shape and this is the flow direction. Here also the tip is here, this is the flow direction. Here if you see, it is formed the V shape in this direction. That means this is the tip of the V and this is the second one step. This is the third one step. That means the flow of the stream is in this direction. This is a stream and this is the V shape. This is the tip of the V shape. This is another tip of the V shape. That is, the water is flowing in this direction. That means the all the small streams are getting collected into this big stream. As we have already seen the image, we can identify now that this is the top of the hill. This is another top. This is another top. This is another top. This is another top. If we join all these highest points, it is called the ridge. And we can see here that the water is getting collected and joining the main stream here in the black color. It is called the valley portion.
Open the AutoCAD and import the Azure sheet. See the units in this AutoCAD using the command units. It is in inches. We can change it to centimeters. Now let us attach the Azure sheet. Now in this Azure sheet, we can see the scale over here, which denotes as 2 cm equals to 1 km. That means if we draw a line of 2 cm on this Azure sheet, it equals to 1 km in the ground in reality. We have already set our units in AutoCAD 2 cm. So first draw a line of 2 cm in AutoCAD. Now we have to align both the topo sheet and the line we have drawn so that it equals to 2 cm on the Azure sheet. Using the command, I will now align the line we have drawn and topo sheet. I am selecting this as Azure sheet as object, and the first source point will be this point, and it is asking to specify the first destination point. This will be the first destination point, and it is asking to specify the second source point. This will be the second source point, and we have to specify the second destination point. This is the second destination point. Now I am pressing enter. It is asking whether to scale. Yes. Now both the Azure sheet and the line have been scaled. Now once we shall verify using the command dimensions di whether it is 2 cm or not. First point, second point, we can see that distance is 2 cm. Now if you draw a line of 2 cm on this Azure sheet, it equals to 1 km on ground in reality. Suppose we want to construct a reservoir in between these two hills because there is a big stream coming from this direction. Using the command polyline, I will draw a line. Take the main stream also, it is pointing the V shape in this direction. That means this is the source point and it is continuing towards the location where we have drawn a red line, that is the proposed reservoir. Here also we can see the V shape pointing upwards. That means the water is coming from the upward direction. As we have already discussed, the catchment area of this reservoir will be the water that is collected in this area through the minor streams and major streams. We can calculate the catchment area by joining the rich portions of the streams. If we see this area, I am drawing a line like this. Above this line, these minor streams are joining the main stream, and the main stream is going in the downward direction like this. This is the hilltop. Whatever the rainfall that is falling in these hilltops, it is divided into half to the upstream and downstream through this minor stream. Now we shall join all the ridge portions of these minor streams and major stream which are coming into the reservoir portion which we have assumed. We have joined all the rich portions through which the water will be collected to the proposed dam sites which we have assumed. Now let us calculate the area of this catchment area using the command area. Now we will select object, and I am selecting this object. It has shown us area as 42.92. In associate, our scale is 2 cm equals to 1 km. That means 1 cm is equal to 0.5 km on ground. So we have to multiply it by 0.5 into 0.5 because it is in square centimeters. I think we have found this very simple to plot the catchment area on Ashes sheet.
In the catchment area we have plotted, I have left some streams without including in the catchment area. I need you to find out in which direction is it with respect to the our proposed dam site, and comment me whether it is in the west, east or in the north direction. Before construction of reservoir, detailed investigations are to be done for reservoir planning. The reservoir planning investigations include engineering surveys, Hydrological investigations and geological investigations. Engineering surveys involves the preparation of contour plan from which the area elevation curve and storage elevation curve are drawn. This figure shows the elevation area and elevation storage curves. And this figure, you can see the contour plan.
The area between the two successive contours can be measured with the help of planimeter.
The geological investigations like groundwater conditions in the region are to be done for water tightness of the basin and for the suitability of foundation of the dam. And the hydrological investigations are to be conducted to study the runoff patterns at the proposed dam site and to determine the storage capacity corresponding to the demand. Creation of hydrograph of the worst flood and to determine the spillway capacity and design.
The final selection of the site of the reservoir depends on the factors that you can see. I have made this video up to my best and hope you liked it. Thank you.